As a photographer, you're losing thousands of dollars every year by not doing this one thing. If you're new to the channel, my name is Gabriel Perez Silva, and I'm a fashion celebrity photographer based out of New York City. Here's some of my work. We've had a lot of new supporters coming on recently, and I really appreciate y'all. If you're new here, I encourage you to check out the other videos I have. There's really some good ones in there. If you saw one of my older videos coming back now, they've gotten a lot better since. So don't sleep on the boy. If you've been watching this past few episodes, I've talked about how the beginning of this year was a really slow period for me. Right now, you know, blessed we are, it's been picking up again. But for the slow period, it had me thinking, yo, what's going on? And outside of my constant daily thinking, yo, how can I make some more money and bread, you know, and for the future, build more income streams and pick up new skills, I started diving a little deeper into something that sounds not far away from a horror story to some of you fellow photographers, and that is learning video. I feel like there's this big thing with like photographers where it's like video, it's like you're saying, like, you know, the boogeyman. And you know, I get how you need to focus on really one thing mainly to like be the best at it and all these things, but it's also great to pick up new skills and learn new skills, and you don't have to post every job you do. A lot of photographers do a ton of jobs and a ton of different settings, and they don't post all their jobs. It's just for money, you know, things like that. And going on to that and to video, I think you can't learn enough new skills, and video, especially in the current climate and societal, you know, stage we're in, it's a great skill to pick up, because even if you're shooting mainly stills, I'm not saying you need to become a cinematographer, but it's a good idea to have general knowledge or a certain knowledge of how to do some video, because it's not, I've noticed more and more in the recent times, I've gotten asked more and more, do you do video as well? You know, there might be some video aspect to this job. Can you do it? Do you video as well? And there's been times where I've had to leave that money on the table because, oh, I wouldn't feel comfortable with it, or I would give it to a friend, or you have to hire somebody on to do it. And I mean, that's fine. I love to put homies on. I'll continue to do so. I'm not going to take every video job. But when the times are slow, or in general, you want to pick up some extra work, then that's a whole nother skill to have. And let me tell you, a ton of these jobs that have been coming in lately that I've been doing, I've been getting a lot more money from video stuff. And that's because I opened myself to bringing those in and also honing in on those video skills. Thanks a lot to you guys, because I really mainly started learning more about video because I wanted to up on my YouTube videos and take them to the next level. And that's really kind of what pushed me to have to learn video a bit more and understand certain things that may have seemed foreign or in a faraway land as a stills person. And luckily because of that, so thanks to y'all, I started getting a little bit better at video. And what really changed the game for me in video, because I was like, you know, I was doing the little thing, you know what I mean? I knew a thing or two about video. And as a photographer, you already have five legs up, you feel me? Because you already have the framing, you can figure out shots, you have the eye for it. So you already have a better vantage point, you know what I mean? Like, you're in a good spot. But the thing that really took my video from being cool to it's good now, it's great. It's like, I can do work with it for real, were two things. And I'm about to put you on, so pull out your notepad, right? Number one. This boy right here, check him out. And this is my Ronin SC2. Now, I got lucky, because I was walking around town one day, stooping. If you're unfamiliar with this term, stooping is when you walk around and you get stuff off stoops that people are leaving or throwing away. It's a real big common practice in New York, because a lot of people pick up, you know, you drop free furniture outside in your sidewalk and somebody picks it up and then you drop it off again. It's like a continuous cycle of stooping. But basically, I was walking around one day and I went to this thing. I think on Facebook Marketplace, somebody was having a little like clear out sale because they were moving. And I showed up and like the boyfriend was a photographer and he was real chill. I think he might even watch his video, who knows? But because I think he subscribed, you know, shout out to the support and the homie. But anyways, he had this. I was like, bro, like, are you selling anything else? And he's like, yo, let me go upstairs, come with me and I'll see what I can find. And he had this and I was like, perfect. I literally had it in my like my to-do list or laundry list of like things I had to buy that period of time. And getting a Ronin, a stabilizer, was one of them. And he pulled it out and he gave me a really good deal. So I was like, yes, I'll take it, whatever. It was really great condition. Honestly, like, you can find these for a really good deal on Marketplace, on anywhere. Like, my experience with stabilizers is really from when I really started in like 2018. And there weren't really these hanging around back then that much, right? It was still like pretty fairly new thing. So I remember my first stabilizer I got was one of those like, you know, like hand weight mechanical ones. And that to me seemed like, bro, like I never used it. I bought it for like 50, 75 bucks to save money and I never used it because it was like, you know, I'm like, it's too ridiculous, you know? And I just kind of like discarded it and I think it was actually missing a piece or whatever, but I ended up not using it. It was like too ridiculous. But, and that worry, that fear had kind of like passed over to like using these because I was like, you know, balancing it seemed like a real like steep feat to accomplish, learning how to balance. You know, learning how to like set it up, the gimbal, all that. But luckily, it was very easy, dude. It was very easy. And you watch one video on YouTube about it and you really figure it out. Of course, like balancing is a little bit of an art. So sometimes it does take a little while. But once it's done, it's pretty much done. You know, sometimes it just moves a little bit or if you change weight. But it's another thing, weight. This one holds up to like 4 kilograms, which is like, I think it's like around like 6 point something pounds. And to give you an example, I use it with my R5, and I use it with my 16-35 meter lens, and it's a version 1. I think it's a little heavier, and it holds it well, and I think that still has a layover like 2 kilograms. And I've used it with my 90D as well. I'll put that on in a second to demonstrate how it works, and no problems. This is a great choice, and it has. So this is a great choice. There's newer ones now, but my only quarrel was this, and the only reason I'm thinking about getting another one is that if I do want like heavier rigs and I like to be prepared for whatever comes, this might be why I might get one of like the pro ones or whatever, just because I might have a heavier load the more I get into video. And I just picked up a pretty big video job that's gonna be like ongoing for a little bit, so I may need that for that. The main thing of why I would get another one with this is that this one does have a portrait like vertical mode, but it's a little weird and I'll try to show it to you in a second. It's a little weird and I don't love it. That's why I feel like I want to get one that's like a bit easier options to do that. I've heard that the Ronin DS3 Mini, which is the newer one, but the mini version is fantastic, incredible for portrait video, like for like Instagram aspect and like Reels aspect and like TikTok and all that. And that one is a cheaper one and it's really like light and compact. And I was about to buy one yesterday, but somebody bought it before me. It has a little bit less of a weight load, but it's still like 4 kilograms, or is it 3? It's still like 4.5 something pounds. It's still like a decent amount. Honestly, I would recommend that one. If you're gonna do like more of a simple setup, I would really recommend that one. But this one has been great, dude. Like if you find this for a good price, you don't have to get the most expensive one off the bat. It's been a great one to learn, great one to work with. Again, I just maybe need a new one for like portrait mode, but still, this has still been, you can still do that. And this is my second game changer when it came to video. It's my R5. Before I was shooting video with my 6D Mark II, my 90D, and it was cool, it was great, but like something was lacking. But dude, when I started shooting video on my R5, like damn, game changer for real, game changer. Like you can just see, it's like a whole different quality, the whole different game, like really like that took it to another level. And those two things combined, you know, have really like made me more confident in saying I can do video and performing in these projects. And the good thing about that is a lot of projects that I've done, or like that a lot of people do, other videographers who I've talked to and directors, they just film it landscape, and then they with like the idea of having some space for cropping in, and then they crop in and zoom in, and if you film it the right way, and like with the R5, the quality is so much better. Trust the way it converts and all that, it'll still be good quality for social media. And you and I've done that, and it looks so great on just shooting in a horizontal landscape and cropping in. So actually, the job I have coming up, I might not even need another Ronin, because if I recall, for example, when you have a job where they need assets for like YouTube, which is landscape, like TikTok, which is this, but it's like the same video, and that's just the easiest way to do, because you're not going to record three videos or two videos, same clips, a lot of portrait, same clips, a lot of landscape. You're just going to record it all landscape and then crop in with that final video for the ones, and then you have it in all different formats. You know what I'm saying? Like, damn, I should have recorded the whole damn video from this angle. The lighting looks so much better. But anyways, I'm gonna give y'all a little demonstration with a Ronin, so I can show you how it looks and how it works and how easy it is, dude. So like I said, right? Well, I'm recording this video on my R5, so I'm not gonna use that one. I'm gonna use my 90D, just for the sake of giving you a demonstration. But and it's not really fully balanced right now, because like I said, like my main camera is on this thing right now, but you'll get the idea. I'm gonna show y'all how easy it is, all right? Just keep your eyes peeled. Y'all saw that? I did that in 5 seconds. You saw how easy that was? Look at that. What? Okay. You see that, dude? And look, this is what I'm talking about. If you wanna do the whole portrait mode, this is what I mean, Lou. This is what I mean. Look, hold up. What? So the issue here is it just kinda points up. It doesn't point like, so you kinda gotta like record like this. Like, and there's actually this cool thing where, hold up, check it out. Honestly, this machine gives me like Transformer vibes. Like it's pretty fire, I'm not gonna lie. But this is what I mean, where it's like the whole portrait mode, it's like a little bit, you know, I'd rather just be able to use it the normal way versus like, gotta do this whole thing, you feel me? But at least you have the option with this gimbal where some don't. I don't know, it starts acting weird in that mode. I don't know, that's why. But most of the stuff I film is like landscape and then crop in. But overall, this has been a great gimbal, and a lot of them don't even have that ability. And then releasing the camera, like, easy money. And on top of all that, I was confused because I didn't do my research and I just went on Amazon and got sold the product. So they sell this Ronin like portrait adapter thing, but it turns out you don't even need it for this one or any of the new ones. All the new ones have like built in, like, you know, like you're straight and you don't need this. Even for mine, you don't need it either. I mean, mine is not like that old. I don't know, I keep saying that, but for some of the older ones, you could buy this, I think, for like the Ronin SE, stuff like that, and this will do the trick for you. Like I said, I haven't had to use this, I haven't used it personally, but I'll link it in the bio, in the description, because maybe you need it. If you already have a Ronin sitting in your garage and you wanna start with that, or you bought it a long time ago and are now ready to move in back into that. Because like always, bro, you don't need the most expensive equipment, especially to start out. You just need something to, it's like strobes, you know, at the end of the day, it still does the trick. You know, it's just like when you start out with one and then then you move on, or whenever you need the more expensive ones for a job, then you can get it.
I feel like why photographers are so scared and reject and push back so much on video is because it's been so pushed on us. You know, we haven't been like, yo, I want to learn video. It's like, yo, like throat, like pushing it down our throats, you know, with the way that social media and everything has come about, where it's like, yo, you basically need to be a videographer to be like a photographer nowadays. That's what it feels like. And I feel like for that reason, a lot of photographers have given so much more pushback, because they're like, yo, like, I don't want to be a videographer because I have to be one. I want to be one because, like, I want to be one or not. And that's kind of like prevented people to open themselves to it and like to even like consider the idea. But like I said, like, it's just like another good skill to have, another good way to make money, another way to like add extra money and extra opportunities to, you know, to your opportunity list. But if you're having a slow period, that's how you be picking up some more money, you know what I mean? Like, cause you feel me? Like, but anyways, I want to hear your thoughts on this. Are you intimidated by video? Do you consider yourself just like a stills person, hybrid? What is it? Let me know your thoughts and see you in the next episode. Thank y'all for tuning in. Oh, and here's my IG link. But have a good one, y'all. See you later.